The river was strong, and Ulle was weak. He did not stand a chance. But soon, the sound of the river faded. Ulle was happy to have firm ground under his feet again. Frog King made sure that his new friend did not drown. But without his sister, he felt like the loneliest child in the world. He just wanted to find Lillimor and go home. To do that, he had to find where the big troll had taken her. Ulla wanted to cry. A couple of hours ago, he had been in his warm bed. Now, he had almost died several times. His sister was gone, and he was soaked in smelly sewer water. Ulle felt bad for the ill-treated giant. Lammas might be big, but he had a warm stone heart. All he longed for was a friend, but his face scared him most. Even so, it seemed like he had found one. Ulle was comforted by the morning sun. He had survived the night, but just barely. At least he had found the stone again. and it felt like it was his sister's way of telling him he was on the right path.
Skola oss på minna Guds godhet. Thank you.
In his past life, Naecken was a simple man that loved playing his violin. But the village did not appreciate his talent. People would frequently bully him, and the only soul that did not was a girl that Naecken fell in love with. One day, the bullying and beatings became so severe that Naecken's anger finally overtook him. He marched into the village, playing forbidden melodies that made everyone dance until their flesh and bone got worn down. They eventually died, leaving behind shuffling corpses, still trying to dance to Naecken's melodies. His love was not spared death either. Devastated, Naecken left the town and lived by the lake, drowning in his sorrow, where he still lures people with his deadly music.
Okay.